We observed the locomotive at White Bear, Minnesota, pulling the tool car and two lounge cars. The train leaves the inspection stop at Boyceville. With slow running and the inspection stops, 261 is only able to make it to Chippewa Falls, 102 miles, on this first day of operation. Thursday morning, September 16th, 261 departs Chippewa Falls over the Chippewa River and soon skirts the southern shore of Lake Wissota. At a leisurely pace, while the air horn developed problems in reaching full tonal range, which restricted it to only occasional use. Some railroads allow steam locomotives being used on excursion trains to ignore hot box detectors that they set off, which occasionally happens owing to heat emissions from the cylinders or firebox. The Wisconsin Central dispatchers and 261's crew proceeded cautiously and stopped to inspect the bearings whenever 261 did trip a detector. Here, the train accelerates away from one such inspection near Atwood, a few miles east of Owen. The train arrives at Stevens Point, where it will spend the night. On Friday morning, 261 approaches the throat of Stevens Point Yard to resume the journey to Fond du Lac. Stevens Point is a division point on the Wisconsin Central, featuring a major yard and the dispatcher's offices. The cylinder cock on the left side is stuck open as 261 leaves the yard. Oshkosh is one of the more interesting railroad towns in Wisconsin. Crossing still protected by wigwag signals, a long stretch of street running, and a swing bridge over the Fox River. Attractions will disappear in 1994 as the Wisconsin Central switches over to the former Chicago and Northwestern track through Oshkosh, which was acquired as part of the 1993 purchase of the Fox River Valley Railroad. Is a former Green Bay and Western business car that was added during a stop at Nenagh.